nous connaît d'eux là,
instead of Isaac,
au lieu que Isaac ait offert un sacrifice,
we know that the goat was offered in Isaac's place.
Nous connaissons que Abraham a été offert la place Isaac.
Let's go to Romans 5.
Le Romains chapitre 5,
verses 12.
Le Romains chapitre 5, verset 12.
We're reading in Creole and in English.
La Bible en créole aussi bien que en anglais.
C'est ça donc quoi? Donc je vais pas qu'à joindre. Romains 5, verset 12. Romans 5, 12. And it says, wherefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, so death passed upon all men, for all have sinned. That was Romans 5 verse 12.
C'était Romains chapitre 5 verset 12.
So the word death.
So le mot mort.
In its spiritual origin.
L'origine spirituelle.
It means separation.
Il veut dire séparation.
So I want you to think. God told Adam, the day that you eat from the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil.
Parce que Dieu dit à Adam, jour où mangez l'homme de la connaissance du bien et du mal.
That day you shall die.
Juste ça, on va mourir.
The reason why the Bible is confusing for many.
Mais c'est que la Bible confuse pour un pile monde.
Is because it's written three different ways.
Parce que les trois façons différentes.
It's written literally.
Écrit littéralement.
Sometimes it's written parabolically.
Parfois, il est paraboliquement.
A parable means is a story, it's not literal.
Et parabole, c'est une histoire, n'est pas littéral.
That's explaining another point.
Qui expliquait pour l'autre point.
And then third, it is written spiritually, or we can say metaphorically.
Et troisièmement, écrit spirituellement ou bien métaphoriquement.
Naturally speaking, Adam did not die.
Naturellement parlant, Adam n'est pas mort.
He lived 930 years.
Adam était vivant 930 ans.
Before he died.
Avant que tu mourir.
But God told Adam that when you eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil.
Mais bon, Adam, pour manger de l'homme de la connaissance du bien et du mal là.
You shall die.
On va mourir.
So death, there's many types of death.
Ouais, ce qu'il y a plusieurs types de mort.
Death means separation.
La mort veut dire séparation.
So when Adam died, he died spiritually first.
Lorsque Adam est mort, il est mort spirituellement d'abord.
And what that means is that the Spirit of God.
Ça veut dire que l'esprit de Dieu
was now separated from the spirit of man.
Il a été séparé de l'esprit de l'homme.
So when you die spiritually,
lorsque vous mourrez spirituellement,
that means that the spirit of God is separated from your spirit.
C'est-à-dire que l'esprit de Dieu est séparé de l'esprit.
When you die physically,
lorsque vous mourrez physiquement,
your soul is separated from your body.
Et non, on séparé de corps.
So now this spirit,
ce qu'on a l'esprit là.
That we call the sinful spirit.
Que nous l'esprit de péché.
That caused Adam to eat from himself.
Qui cause Adam de manger de pas lui-même.
See, the knowledge of the tree of good and evil.
Ou connaissance du bien et du mal.
It's not a physical tree.
C'est pas un pied qui est physique.
See, the serpent says that if you eat from this tree.
C'est pas du mal que si que vous mangez de fruit ça.
You shall be like God.
Va devenir même si avec mon Dieu.
And we can see that today.
Donc, comme aujourd'hui,
men has become like God.
Et les hommes devenus même si mon Dieu.
Men decide what is good.
Les hommes décident de ce qui est bon.
And what is evil.
Et ce qui est mal.
They do not rely on God's word to dictate what is good and evil.
Ne pas dépendre de la parole de Dieu pour dicter ce qui est bon ou ce qui est mal.
That means that whatever they think is good is good.
Ne pas dire que vous pensez qui est bon ou bon.
They have put themselves in God's place. And that because we are limited in our knowledge.
C'est parce que nous
and God is omniscient.
Et bon Dieu est omniscient.
When we go our own way.
Lorsque nous allons dans notre chemin pas nous.
And we eat from the fruit of our own minds.
Et nous mangeons dans le fruit de notre pensée pas nous.
We are now separated. separated from the Spirit of God.
Qu'on a nous séparé de l'Esprit de Dieu.
So when Jesus came,
c'est lorsque Jésus est venu,
he was the last to fulfill the law of substitution.
C'est le même qui était en dernier pour remplir de la loi de substitution.
This separate attitude that caused us to be divided from God was to be judged.
Action, ça fait des choses que vous ne savez pas être de bon Dieu, c'était pour te juger.
And when the Pharisees said,
lorsque les pharisiens ont dit,
they said, well, we don't want, because Pilate said that, well, we release one prisoner.
Ils ont dit que ça fait que nous relâchons un prisonnier.
And Pilate brought Barabbas,
et puis là, pour Barabbas, Barabbas,
which was a thief and a killer. And that person, he was the one that was supposed to be crucified on those three crosses. That central cross was supposed to be for Barabbas.
So on a taken trois fois. Certainement, c'était supposé pour Barabbas.
But they said no.
Mais on dit non.
They said, don't give us Barabbas instead and crucify Jesus.
Mais c'est pas pour Barabbas et puis crucifier Jésus en place lui.
And when Peter did not understand this,
Pierre n'est pas comprendre ça.
He took a knife and he wanted to cut the soldier's head. To cut the soldier's ears. And Jesus said, no one takes my life.
Jésus dit pour ça que pas d'autre que moi qui est capable de prendre vie moi.
I give my life.
By vie moi.
I could have called 10,000 angels.
J'ai carrément 10,000 anges.
No one takes my life.
Aucun monde pas capable de prendre vie moi.
I give my life.
Moi, by vie moi.
Jesus said, I'm giving it.
Jésus dit que moi, by vie moi.
So Jesus.
So Jésus.
Was crucified.
Il était crucifié.
On the cross.
Sur la croix.
Barabbas should have been crucified.
Barabbas est supposé crucifié.
Now you're probably thinking, you said, I thought he died for me.
Yeah.
I thought he took my place.
Je que pour moi.
But you said that cross is for Barabbas.
Barabbas.
Well, that is the answer.
Well, ça c'est réponse là.
You are Barabbas.
Oh, c'est Barabbas.
I am Barabbas.
Moi, c'est Barabbas.
We are Barabbas.
Nous, c'est Barabbas.
We are guilty.
Nous, coupables.
Of murder and stealing and all. If you're guilty of one, you're guilty of all.
Si vous coupable de un seul bâton, coupable de tout.
But Jesus,
mais
on
Jesus,
that cross,
sous quoi ça?
Took our place.
Il prend place, non.
And every nail.
Et chaque grain de clou.
That they put on his hands.
Que t'es cloué même.
Praise the Lord. Was for us.
C'était pour nous-mêmes.
Was that he was crucified.
Il était crucifié.
The sinful nature that we have.
Et nature de péché ça que nous gagnons.
That wants us to lean on our own understanding.
Il voulait pour nous dépendre sur propre compréhension.
That wants us to lean on our own thoughts.
Sur propre pensée par nous.
And now we are. So when Jesus died, it was a judgment.
Tout lorsque Jésus était mort, c'était un jugement.
It was a judgment on our nature.
C'était un jugement de nature.
It was a judgment on the sinful nature that separated us from God.
Un jugement de nature, ça qui séparait nous de mon Dieu.
So what must we do?
Ce bien-aimé, qui s'en supposé?
What does this mean? Is there an example beyond the meaning of the cross? For us today.
Est-ce que pour exemple et sous quoi ça peut être sous quoi pour nous-mêmes je dis.
Beyond the understanding that he died for you and I.
Au-delà de compréhension que il mourit pour nous-mêmes avec vous.
Is there any other things that we can glean from it today?
Est-ce que l'autre bagage que nous apprendre ou bien tirer de ça je dis.
I'm going to give you just a couple really quick.
Bah bon quelques adieux rapidement.
The first.
Première.
Is understanding the affliction.
C'est la compréhension sur l'affliction.
And how it can get you an intimate relationship with God.
Qui est capable d'avoir une relation intime avec mon Dieu.
Jesus was crucified.
Jésus était crucifié.
And he told us to carry all cross.
Il dit comme ça que dis-nous pour nous porter quoi.
If you look at a lot of people, they don't celebrate the crucifixion in their religion.
Ce gars d'un peuple dans la religion, ils passent des crucifixions.
They're not celebrating. Isn't it appropriate that we're celebrating a crucifixion?
Est-ce que pas droit pour mettre la célébration de la crucifixion par la étrange?
Why would we celebrate this affliction?
Pourquoi ça n'a pas célébré affliction ça?
Why would we celebrate? Yeah, you know, but why would we try to remember that?
Oui, pour nous mettre pour que ça n'a pas essayé son
Jésus. But Jesus told us to carry our cross too.
Jésus dit nous pour nous porter pourquoi pas tout.
So there is an understanding that serving God doesn't mean that you won't go through trials. Serving God doesn't mean that you won't go through problems. Because if Jesus, the only begotten Son of God, was crucified, that means that we can't say that if we're going through some problems, it's not fair. How do you respond to challenges? Do you flee the presence of God?
Est-ce que vous courez devant la présence de Dieu?
In the midst of trials?
La midst of chagrin?
In the midst of problems?
La midst of problèmes?
Or do you fellowship with Him in the midst of
that? Est-ce que vous êtes en communion avec bon Dieu la midst?
You cannot know God until you know Him in affliction. I'm
going to
say that again. You cannot know God if you do not know Him in affliction. It's not what people
want to
hear, but you cannot know God if you don't know Him in affliction.
C'est pas ça qu'on veut dire, mais on peut bien comprendre Dieu si que on pas reconnaître lui la mitaine de chaque.
Some affliction,
affliction,
is to show you the power of God.
C'est pour montrer la puissance de Dieu.
Not every affliction is there to destroy you. Say it. Not every affliction is there to destroy you.
C'est pas n'importe affliction qui l'a pour tout. C'est pas toute affliction qui l'a pour détruire.
Some affliction is there to raise you up.
Il y a une affliction qui l'a pour lever.
Some affliction is there to put you in a better position.
Il y a une affliction qui l'a pour aider dans une position qui l'aide.
Some affliction God allows to come so that you may know God in the power of His resurrection.
Bon Dieu peut mettre pour qu'on bon Dieu là vitesse de charge de l'eau.
Hallelujah. When some affliction is to know God and to suffer. But some affliction is to know God and the power of His resurrection. You see, Goliath was not there to destroy David. But he was there to promote David. When you're going through that affliction, but without it, you won't know God. How do you know that God is a healer if you never were sick? How would you know that God is a provider if you never needed provision? He intends you to be in the situation and to know. That you went through everything for, and looking at God
And
said, do not harm that child.
I have
provided provision.
Abraham
called him Jehovah Jireh. Because he realized that he was the God of provision. When he needed it. Sometimes we need it. Not all the time, though. That we go through things is to understand God and the power of His resurrection. Sometimes some affliction is so that we may be able to minister to others. Look at 2 Corinthians 1, verse 3 to 7.
2 Corinthians 1, verse 3 to 7.
Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 1.
2 Corinthians chapter 1.
Verse 3 to 7.
Verse 3 to 7.
And it says, blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort. Verse 4. Who comfort us in our tribulation. Listen. That we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort where we ourselves are comforted of God. For as the suffering of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also abounded by Christ. And whether we be afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same suffering which we also suffer. Or whether we be comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. And our hope of you is steadfast, knowing that ye are partakers of the suffering, so shall ye be also in the consolation.
Béni soit Dieu, le Père de notre Seigneur Jésus-Christ, le Père de la miséricorde et le Dieu de toute consolation. Verset 4. Il nous console dans toutes nos afflictions, afin que par la consolation dont nous sommes l'objet de la part de Dieu, nous puissions confier, nous puissions consoler ceux qui se trouvent dans quelques affliction. Verset 5. Car de même que les souffrances de Christ abandonnent en nous, de même notre consolation abandonne par Christ. Verset 6. Si nous sommes affligés, c'est pour votre consolation et pour votre salut. Si nous sommes consommés, c'est pour votre consolation qui se réalise par la patience à supporter les mêmes souffrances que nous endurons.
When God calls you,
lorsque Dieu te appelle,
we are there to be comforters of each other.
Nous là pour nous conforter, Lord.
We're there to help each other.
We're là pour nous aider, Lord.
It's not always about you.
C'est pas tout le temps qui pour avec vous-même.
Not everything is about you.
C'est pas tout bagaille qui centre au-dessus de vous-même.
Some things God allows you to go through.
Et quel bagaille que bon Dieu permet que vous passez.
Is so that you may comfort someone else.
C'est pour que vous comportez pour l'autre monde.
That is going through the same thing.
Il va entendre le même bagaille là.
It is so important.
Important.
I remember when, man, I went through some tough times.
So j'ai dépassé des moments qui difficiles.
And I know that in those times,
et connais que le moment c'est là, yo,
when I had to bury my baby,
moi, j'ai enterré petit, moi, yo.
You can't. I mean, the pain that those type of things bring. But I knew it was a purpose.
Because
God used me to comfort others that was going through similar trials. Some things you go through is not about you. But God wants to use you as a vessel. How he was open to being used of God? How
he
was open to being used of God?
Did
you say, God, use me? Use me to help somebody else. Use me to encourage somebody else. You see, when you go through something, I don't waste my pain. I do not waste my pain.
Yeah.
Because if I'm going through it, I know the final reason is for me to grow. That's the final reason we go through affliction. Some affliction produces growth. If you're going through something, when I'm going through something very difficult, first thing I say, God, you got to reveal me something. You got to give me a word. I'm not
going to
waste this pain. I know that if I'm going through this, because you know, if you don't get a revelation, your season doesn't change. You see, revelation changes seasons. You see, the people of Israel, they kept on going around and around because they never got a revelation. They never could enter the promised land because they never got a revelation. If you're going through something today, are you growing because of your pain? Are you growing because of your tribulation? Hallelujah. This is why in Isaiah, and I'm not going to read it because of time, but I just want you to write it down. He calls it the bread of affliction.
Le pain d'affliction.
He called it the bread of affliction.
Le pain d'affliction.
Why would he call it bread? Because sometimes there's provision in the midst of your trials.
Parce que parfois, le temps d'être chargé, il y a une provision là-dedans.
Your test becomes your testimony.
Ouais, test, vous devenez un témoignage.
And the steps become a stepping stone.
Et étape, vous devenez un échelle.
So that you can continue growing and going to where God puts you.
Pour continuer grandir et aller côté que bon Dieu ait décidé pour vous.
I do want to read one more scripture. Let's go to 1 Peter 5:10.
Dans 1 Pierre chapitre 5, verset 10. 1 Pierre 5, verset 10.
But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish you, strengthen you, and settle you.
Suffering.
What he's going to do, he's going to, the word perfect here
Le mot perfectionner là
means mature.
Il dit maturité.
Remember, Jesus said that every branch that's in me shall bear fruit.
Jésus a dit que tout ce qui va dans moi-même va porter fruit.
You see, when a fruit is ripe,
lorsque fruit a bien mûri,
and it's ready to, that means that you can eat it.
Ça veut dire que tu peux manger.
That's what perfection here means.
C'est ça perfection.
It doesn't mean without fault.
Il va dire que sans faute.
But there's a maturity.
Mais au niveau de maturité.
There's a maturity.
Bon maturité.
When you are after you've gone through some stuff. The things that used to bother you don't bother you. The things that used to distract you don't distract you. Because your eyes are, you done gone through too much. I remember talking to my brother and my sister. I was going through some trials. And God finally started to bless me. And while I'm trying to bless somebody else, they
want to
give me some problems.
Problem.
But I said, man, I done gone too far. I'm too close to my finish line
to
stop and fight these fools for what they're doing. They
want to
be prejudiced, they want to be racist. Let's be their problem. Let me keep on moving towards my goals. Because a lot of times when you stop to fight somebody,
parce que plus fois, lorsque vous campez pour partir avec le monde,
you forget what you were working on.
Oubliez ce qui sont à travailler.
Now you got to respond to them.
Quand vous avez pas fait mon travail, bon.
You've elevated the person to get your full attention. You focus on them. And then you forgot your purpose. So after you suffered and you've grown a little bit, the things that used to bother you, the things that used to distract you, are not
going
to distract you
anymore.
Because your eyes are fixed on the goal.
Parce que Dieu fixé sur le Seigneur.
These are just some lessons that we can get.
Ça, c'est quelque chose qu'on peut joindre.
From the death, burial, and affliction of Christ.
De la mort et de Jésus-Christ.
Not only.
Non seulement.
He died.
Que lui mourit.
He took our place.
Lui prend place, non.
He took the Barabbas in his place.
Lui prend Barabbas qui l'a la caméra. Lui prend place là.
But I learned that I too must go through some affliction.
Apprendre que moi-même aussi de passer cette affliction.
And that the affliction that I go through,
affliction ça peut pas endurer.
Sometimes,
et parfois,
it's to elevate me.
C'est pour lever plus haut.
Sometimes it's to realize that God can be a provider.
Parfois c'est pour réaliser que mon Dieu est capable. Mon Dieu c'est un provision.
Sometimes it's to see him in the power of his resurrection.
Papa, c'est pour moi la puissance de sa résurrection.
Sometimes
et parfois,
it's to get more close to him.
C'est pour m'approcher plus près de lui-même.
So that I can talk to him in suffering.
Pour qu'il parle avec lui dans la souffrance.
So that he can use me.
Pour qu'il serve avec moi.
To comfort others that are going through something similar.
Pour comforter les autres qui passent même cette charge.
And then finally.
Et finalement.
Some things that we go through is to help us grow.
C'est pour aider nous dans la croissance.
So that we can enter new levels.
Pour être capable d'entrer dans un niveau qui est supérieur.
In our purpose with Christ.
Dans le but nous dans Christ.
In our purpose in Christ.
Dans le but nous qui est dans Christ.
Let's surrender our purpose to His.
Let's
surrender.
On nous remet le but nous en lui-même.
So that we're not eating from the tree of what we think is good and what we think is evil.
Avec le parfum de la fruit, ça que nous pensons qui bien ou bien qui mal.
But let us eat out of the tree of life.
Mais on ne mange de l'arbre de vie.
Let us eat out of what God's will for us is.
On ne mange de ça que volonté bon Dieu qui est pour nous-mêmes.
Let us surrender.
On nous remet.
To an omniscient God.
À un Dieu qui est omniscient.
That knows all things.
Qui connaît toute bagarre.